Latin football is the home of the Super Bowl, and this historic matchup is brought to you by EA Sports. It's the Packers and the Jets, and it comes your way next.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Tonight, it is all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion New York Jets taking on the NFC champions, the Green Bay Packers. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, safe to say it has been a long time since we talked about the Jets in the Super Bowl. You have to go back to Joe Namath in Super Bowl III to find their last involvement in this game.
And Brandon, when I go back through the recesses of my mind, when Joe Namath was running off the field, Super Bowl III, forget it. I'm not counting up those years. Let's just say it's been a long time. And there's Jets fans who stuck around through it all. And what a night this could be if they could finish off what they've set out to do.
And meanwhile, for the Packers, not many could have predicted they'd make it back to this. The 2023 season has one game left. Here we go. Super Bowl 58 underway from Vegas. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. So here comes the Packers offense now onto the field. They're brought out by a guy who's become something of a journeyman. He's played for five teams across the last six seasons, the well-traveled Teddy Bridgewater.
As we begin the Super Bowl, we're looking at one of the game's most important players. And whether he's the centerpiece of the offense or taking a backseat to his teammates, offenses always look to the quarterback to be a leader in moments like this. He's got to be that calm, composed pillar out there who stays level-headed and keeps everyone focused on the task at hand.
Balled at the 26, second and seven. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot, he had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you.
And down he goes! The pressure getting to Bridgewater. Carl Lawson in there to drop him for a six-yard loss, and that will lead to fourth down. On fourth down, Matt Hawk to punt it away. Back deep for the Jets, Mecole Hardman. And taken right on the 30. A solid punt, but also a nice return there of 14 yards. And the Jets will take over first and 10. So now here comes the Jet offense as they get ready to take over. Now they're brought out by a man drafted over a decade ago out of Arizona, has made at least one start in every season. That's Nick Foles.
And no doubt he's living out a dream right now. He's had dating back to his first days of playing football as a kid. But he certainly can't get lost in the moment right now. There's still a Super Bowl to be played, and his offense, they're looking to him to be their leader. You can take it all in when it's over. Right now, you've got the biggest game of your life to win.
Here's second and 10. Here's Foles. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down. Now Foles. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
I'm quite sure that they envisioned a much better start to this game when they practiced all week, but they failed on that third down play. That brings up fourth down, and they'll probably have to punt it away.
And here's Morstead now as he sends this one away. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
His second catch in the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Play fake. Bridgewater. Caught on the right side by Jones. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and that'll bring up second down. Now Bridgewater. He'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. John Franklin Myers in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense, so he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
Third and long now after the sack, and we'll see if Bridgewater has a response. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here.
Encroachment.
A bit of a jump there, CD. He breaks the line, and that'll be 5 yards.
And you've got to stay more disciplined than that, Brandon. That's just a free gift to the offense.
And the penalty helps, but not a whole lot. It's still third and long. Here's Bridgewater. Setting up the screen here, Aaron Jones. And he'll be taken down well before the first at about the 36-yard line. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of 2 there. Here's Matt Hawk now to punt. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. Fair catch called for and made at the 16 or maybe the 17-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt.
And the Jets will take over.
Foles. He'll rifle this one deep right side. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Brees Hall with a first touchdown of this Super Bowl and a long one at that. And the Jets are on the board first here this afternoon. So a long play for our first points in the Super Bowl.
No doubt about it, and what we see here is something that we saw all year long from them. The ability to strike from anywhere on the field. How about the way they got it started in this one?
Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Those are the ones the offensive coordinators dream about. One play drives from that distance. What an effort. It results in the touchdown.
The Packers ready to take over offensively.
They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. Here's Bridgewater. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
And I could see the officials kind of looking at each other down there, silently wondering, does this meet the level of grounding? Fortunately, he did have a receiver in the area, but I have seen less obvious throwaways called as penalties.
He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. This now a 3rd and 4. Bridgewater. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he's going to have the Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, a lot of times when you get a manageable third down situation like this, you have to think about your tight end, and he comes through for him, picking up the first down.
That brings us to the end of one in Super Bowl 58. Much more to come from Las Vegas after this.
7-0 is our score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Welcome back to the date on the calendar we circle every year, Super Bowl Sunday. Brandon Godd and Charles Davis here with you as we get set to begin quarter 2.
So the completion good for 6 yards, and that will bring up second down. Bridgewater to throw it. They're unable to connect, but a late flag comes in. And the contact may have come too early. So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense. First and 10. Throwing, Bridgewater. Drops it to Jones in the flat. Flashy little move, but unable to reach the 40. So give him 2 yards there on the completion, and it'll be second down. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And he's going to get this down close to a first at about the Jets' 37.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Sauce Gardner picks it off, and the Jets are going to take over at their own 28-yard line. Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
Andy, you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit, and that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
Now Hall to start the drive. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
This Super Bowl, of course, just a huge one for this head coach. The first time he's walked the sidelines in a game of this magnitude, and you know, I might normally ask the cliche, what's going through his mind right now? But maybe the better question, CD, what do you think are the pitfalls of being a first-time head coach in this game?
Well, you know it's something that he thought about, Brandon, and he had to, and he was thinking about it long before he got to this stage. As the season progressed, and he saw that his team was good, if he was smart, he started to make plans right then and there. Reach out to other coaches who've been there before. Find out how they handled winning, losing, handling all the ticket situations, travel, practice, all those things. And then trust your gut, make your best decision, and put it all out there and give your team their best chance to win.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 44-yard line.
And that's well executed there on third down, and I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
On first and 10, it's Hall. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
Well, partner, I have to say they caught him in the right defense there. Nickel set, fifth defensive back on the field, and they love to run against that because now you typically get a bigger blocker on a smaller defender.
Yeah, because those DBs like you, they want the interception. They're not as worried about the running play, right?
Not at all. I still remember being in school, and one of my offensive line teammates used to say, boy, I'd love to come back here and hit you little people.
Good run there.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
First throw into the hands here of Hardman. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. Out of the gun now on third down. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Like what I see so far out of this defense, because they've been showing their best coverages on third down. So far, only allowed one conversion on a handful of attempts. One area of their game plan that they've executed to perfection.
Zerline's kick is up and through, and that will extend their lead even further. So, Charles, they get to them with their first turnover of the game and then make it hurt a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball up, what's the first thing a coach tells his defense? Don't let them score off of this. You've got to put out the fire. In fact, in 2021, that's what one NFL coach termed his defense. The firemen, go out there, guys, and don't let them put some points on the board.
The Green Bay offense ready to take over.
And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, and this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
A second down throw for Bridgewater. Pitch and catch to Moreau, the tight end. And he's upended after a gain of four up to the 25-yard line. On third down, Bridgewater. And this is going to be incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down.
I know this offense was expecting to do big things, but it certainly hasn't turned out that way, at least not through the first three drives. They're definitely going to have to put their heads together and start concocting some offense that'll move the ball downfield.
Yeah, call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And that will come the offense as they take over. The Jets going to take over now late in this first half. And with a 10-0 lead, you figure they won't try to do anything foolish here. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And his throw here is going to be incomplete. He was out there waving his arms saying, throw it here, dropped it, not a good look.
Well, all I can do is just look at him with contempt on that one. As a defensive back, I'm saying, not as an announcer. Just like, really?
A little bit of a diva look, isn't it?
Yeah, very much so. Because I think what happens is he just had too much time to think. He's wide open now. Here comes the ball. And he doesn't concentrate and drops it.
Third down, he'll drop to throw. And he will not be able to get away as Foles is taken down. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. The Packers with a football here late in this first half. They're certainly in need of some kind of points here before the end of the half. A field goal or something being shut out right now. They could really use some momentum before they head into halftime. On first and 10, Bridgewater. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. Second down, Bridgewater. Left side on a dime, and it looks like he's got it. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
When the spotlight is at its brightest, and let's face it, it's the Super Bowl, those types of plays come out, don't they?
Absolutely. A big-time catch on the biggest of stages.
Do you think that that one's going to live on? We're going to see this for a long time.
Definitely going to live on forever with him, that's for sure.
No doubt.
And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. It'll go as a gain of four, and it'll be second down. Off the play fake, Bridgewater. Got dives over the middle, and that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets' 18. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime.
And this offense has been a little slow to get going, but some signs of life here in this second quarter. They're moving it pretty good. And that helps the cause as well. Good yardage and another first down.
And his kick is good. And they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. And maybe a moral victory of sorts. They're on the board here late in the first half, but this offense just hasn't looked that sharp.
Yeah, but at least they got the 3 points, right? At least have something to, quote-unquote, hang their hats on and maybe feel a little bit better about themselves as they head to the half.
All that remains is to snap this once, and that'll do it for the first half of play. So we've come upon halftime in the big one, the Super Bowl. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. What a season this has been. Hard to believe it ends tonight, as we'll get back to you guys for the second half of this Super Bowl in just a moment.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. Here's the Jets offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. And I think you'd have to say their coaching staff, all things considered, had to be pleased with their performance in the first half of this Super Bowl.
Definitely pleased. Doing their best not to show it to their team, of course, because as you and I both know, their mantra all season long has been finish. Get the job done. They know how close they are to lifting that trophy. One more solid half of football, and they can do exactly that.
Ball again on second down. And he stopped after a gain of one. Not enough. Still a yard to go on third down. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. They'll run with Hall. Now it looks like we'll get a timeout, and we will. We've got an injured Packer on the field. We'll take a break and get a report from Vegas after this. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And check down complete to Hall. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Second and 5. On play action, they'll throw. Throwing quickly there, but it's incomplete.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
They're going to look to throw. And it is caught. They'll have the first down, and more than that. All the way in. Touchdown, New York. Tyler Conklin, 59 yards. And the Jets will extend their third quarter lead here in this Super Bowl. That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a two-touchdown lead, right? Because you have taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. So here are the Packers now. They get set for their first possession of half number two. Well, the opposition laid down the challenge, an opening drive touchdown here to start the second half. And Charles, now you feel like this group needs to get an answer because this all of a sudden is a two-score game.
Yeah, you're right about that. What was a small, manageable spread to overcome? A little bit more daunting now. I think you're exactly right. Pressure is on because you don't want them getting the ball back with a chance to really extend this lead out.
From the 21, here's the second down and 6. They'll go again to Jones. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. Bridgewater. To the double coverage and intercepted. Sauce Gardner picks it off, and they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. Well, and I saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy and can he step into a throw. And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
Now the Jets offense about set to take over as they head onto the field. And they'll have good field position here following the interception and a chance to build on their lead as they start with a first and 10. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. He'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And he'll get it down this time to the 17. 63 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
On first down, right back to Hall. Down he goes at the 10 with a solid pickup of 8.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
And he'll only get a yard to bring up 3rd and 1. It looks like the Packers have added an extra DB on 3rd down. Now Foles. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down.
Looked like both sides were anticipating a quick throw there, and the defense was ready to jump in and deny it, and they did.
Here's Foles. And it'll find the open man. That's complete. And inside the 5 here before he's out of bounds right at the 3. Looks like a jumbo set with 3 tight ends here for 1st and goal. And they'll let the fullback try and take him home. Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. Could have been a costly mistake, but as it turns out, they keep possession.
You can't give away these types of opportunities in the red zone. And I'm sure that was flashing through his brain as the ball escaped his hands. Fortunately for him.
And he is going to be taken down. And that should be the final play of this 3rd quarter. And that one really pushes him back. A loss of 9. And now it's 3rd and goal after the sack. We are through 3 quarters of play here from Allegiant Stadium in Super Bowl 58. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Folks, welcome back to the biggest stage in sports, the Super Bowl. And now we get down to the good stuff, the 4th and final quarter. They wind up with 6 on the hook up there, but it's not enough. 4th and goal.
Then we got to give a little tip of the cap for the defense there. Zone coverage, locked it in tight, made it really difficult because they tried the crossing route against it, and it worked for a completion, but you have to know where the sticks are on 3rd down. Didn't get beyond them. No pickup.
So that almost certainly the final piece to this puzzle, a 3-score lead. I don't think there's any coming back from there.
Well, you know, normally I'd get on you for giving up on the game right here, but I do think you're right in this case. This late in the game, 2 scores is tough enough. 3, I'm with you. That seems out of the question.
And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And it's becoming more and more apparent that this is just not going to be their night. That Lombardi Trophy so close, but the expectations simply have not matched the results as they start on this drive, 1st and 10. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. 25 yards there on the catch and run. Bridgewater now from the 50. That's complete. He finds Jaden Reed. And that's good for a gain of 6, and it's 2nd down. To throw, Bridgewater. He'll complete this one to Watson. A gain of 5, good enough for the 1st down. Now Bridgewater. A complete once again to Watson. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And they're going to speed things up here. And again, it's Bridgewater. On the out route, Dobbs brings it in. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10, marking down at the 9. 1st and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Throwing is Bridgewater. Caught on the right
sideline. And a loose football.
Wow, that ball is knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base and scoring.
And it's a Packers touchdown. Jaden Reed, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Packers are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter.
So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still two scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you'd kept them out of the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And the Jets have got it. The fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Hall again on 2nd down. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. It's a loss of 1 yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. 3rd and 10. Expect a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Here's Hall again. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin them back. So the Packers down 20-10. 1:51 on the clock. They've come so far this year, but they need 2 quick scores late in this Super Bowl. And now a throw on 1st down there, but it's incomplete.
Well, they've certainly had trouble unlocking this defense through 3.5 quarters, so I don't expect it to get any easier now. You know they're going to be sitting back and waiting on everything, and they force an incompletion there.
Another throw on 2nd down, and this one incomplete as well.
Back-to-back incompletions, but we know this is definitely 4-down territory. Time not on their side. I don't think they want to try and get the 1st down in 2 installments. I think they got to go and get it right here, right now.
Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on 3rd.
That means it's just 1 last chance left, and this has to be a 1st down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
4th down, 10 yards to go. Here's Bridgewater. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by the linebacker, C.J. Mosley, and he'll return it to the 24-yard line.
So many times we end a game, and as we're recapping it, we're talking about what offenses did and how they won the game. Let's flip this one over. The defense, they frustrated the offense the entire ball game. That's why they're walking out of here with a victory.
And they're going to love to walk out of here with that as their final act, that interception. Good way for them to end it. Another drive coming up for New York's offense. And a few kneel downs should come very close to finishing this one off, depending on whether or not we see any defensive timeouts. They still have 2, but using them would just be prolonging what's really already been decided. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Another run on 2nd down, trying to cover up. And he will have a Jets 1st down, and that should just about do it.
I hope you guys enjoyed the content that I've been putting out. These Madden videos, I've been having really good fun. But anyways, guys, we won the Super Bowl. It's been a good season, and hopefully season 2 coming out, we'll win another one. But anyways, guys, hope you all enjoy it. Thanks for watching. Thanks for all the love on the channel. And I'll talk to you guys in the next one.
Getting to hoist that Lombardi trophy. You know, we've talked to guys that have done it, and they say there's no better feeling in sports.
I don't know how there can be. The journey to get to this game is incredible. And then to finally break through and win it when all eyes are on this game alone because there's nothing else going on, that's just got to be absolutely amazing. That, the task, incredible. But the accomplishment, forever.